click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
So friends, now we are going to talk about that is what are the physical as well as the chemical property of aluminium. So since we know that aluminium is the one which is basically having a metallic character, while that of the boron which has a non-metallic character. And now, especially we are talking about the aluminium and what are the physical appearance, what are the different kind of properties that it could exhibit, that is what we are going to cover in this topic. So let us do that. So talking about the physical property of aluminium is basically having a metallic character, and obviously since it is a metal, it will have basically a very shiny luster on it. And it is basically a white like silvery color metal. And talking about the other properties, like it is having a good property of it conducts a good amount of electricity through it, as well as it also conducts thermal conductivity. And that's the reason that it's a comparatively different from that of the boron. And talking about the other one, that is the other properties of or the other physical properties of the aluminium, is that aluminium can form alloy. And those alloy, the famous alloy that we know is basically duralumin, and the other alloys, they are basically used in aircraft so as to make the material to be very lightweight, yet they will have a very good tensile strength on it. And that's the reason that they are used in aircrafts. And so this is where certain kind of physical property that I was talking about, and certain other things like alum. So alum is a kind of a substance which consists of aluminium, but that is also used in purification of water, and they are also used as an antiseptics also. Certain compounds of that consist of aluminium that are used in antiseptics. So now let us talk about the chemical property. So talking about the chemical properties that could be exhibited by the aluminium, and those are as follows. So starting with the first one, that is what happens when the aluminium is reacted with acid. So it has been noted that the aluminium, it can easily react with that of HCl as well as that of H2SO4. So now let us understand that what is the reaction. And in this case, basically, the 2 moles of aluminium is reacted with 6 moles of HCl so as to form that is aluminium trichloride or aluminium chloride, along with that of the evolution of hydrogen gas. While in the next reaction, that is when 2 moles of aluminium is been reacted with that of 6 moles of H2SO4, then the product that has been obtained is basically aluminium sulfate, and the other products are basically SO2 as well as 6 moles of H2. But now, the main thing is why it doesn't react with the other mineral acid, that is nitric acid. The reason behind that is aluminium is not that much reactive with that of the nitric acid. The reason behind that is aluminium forms an oxide layer on it, so that acts like a protective layer on it, and that's the reason that nitric acid doesn't react with that of the aluminium, while the other 2 mineral acids like that of HCl and H2SO4, they can easily react. So this was a certain reaction that I was talking about, a certain chemical property that could be exhibited by the aluminium. And now let us talk about the other property, that is, so this was a reaction which was related with acid. And now let's talk about the next one, when what happens if the aluminium is treated with base or alkaline. So now this is a reaction where basically aluminium is being treated with that of a base like NaOH. And so in this case, basically 2 moles of aluminium is reacted with 2 moles of sodium hydroxide so as to obtain, that is, basically 2 moles of sodium meta aluminate, that is MaAlO twice, along with that of 3 moles of H2. So this is what we have, and that is NaAlO2 is basically the main ingredient where basically we could prepare, or during this process basically we can also extract that is aluminium from the different other ores, and that is the main ingredient from where which we could obtain aluminium. So this is what I want to talk about. So that's it. Thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you have got to know about the various properties of the aluminium. I hope you share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.